Turn on the fan. Turn on the radio. Listen on your smart device through the internet. Asia Online Radio. Scotland's voice in the West.
It's Pro2sday! That's right, folks. Once again, I'm your host, Kid Thompson, and we are back. And this time, we're smashing through the snow, as you may have been able to guess. We've got the UEWA heavyweight champion, Andy Wilde, taking on the big strong man, Inaugural. We've also got Umar Mohammed, who is the Asian sensation, taking on Caleb Valhalla, the Viking. And as well as that, we've got a four-way elimination match. For the Bells Division Championship, we've got Rosie Nyte, we've got Rubi Roberts, we've got Ashley Vega, and we have Harmony Skye. This is an episode you do not want to miss, folks. Let's stay tuned and see what happens.
This first bout is going to be scheduled for a fall of one, and it is for the UEWA Championship. Bringing in first, the challenger.
And there he is, the big strong man himself, Inaugural. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Pro2sday. Welcome to Smashing Through the Snow. I'm Kid Thompson and I'm sat here in the commentary booth with Swab Gav.
How you doing, kids? All set for this match? Title championship once again, UEWA championship?
Yes, indeed. And it's a very appropriate match because we've just had confirmation on the Pro2 Facebook page that we're now part of the UEWA network.
Fantastic. It wasn't going to take long. Pro2 is definitely on the up.
Yes, indeed. And I believe this was this our first UEWA match? No, I'm telling lies. It's our second UEWA match because we had Looking Sharp and Michael Green at Start the Fire.
That's right, back at our home of Anbank.
This time we're here at Bouncestation in Irvine.
Certainly a bit of bounce about Inaugural.
Oh, the man is a live wire, absolute live wire.
He's an entertainer. I love watching this guy perform, kid.
Oh yeah, me too. Although I'm not so fond of listening to him perform. Listening to him screaming.
Aye, let's just see. He could come down a pitch or two. He certainly knows how to get that crowd moving.
Oh, he does. And here he is, the UEWA heavyweight champion.
Dad bod god Andy Wilde, doesn't he get much bigger than him? Fantastic
not.
Performer, kid.
Good star in Europe. One of the best heavyweights in the world today in this interview with him.
Without a doubt, he's worked for it. He's been about a while as Andy Wilde.
Absolutely, yeah, and that belt there, the lineage of that belt, held previously by none other than a certain Drew McIntyre or Drew Galloway.
A performer for a local area, big air lad is Drew. I still like to call him Mr. Galloway myself. But
yes,
the man is not a myth, he is definitely a legend.
Yes, a living legend, and another living legend is Andy Wiles.
Shout out to him.
The dad bod god. Look at him vault over that top rope beautifully. You love to see it.
Being a father myself, kid, I wouldn't be trying that one.
No, no. A beautiful young lady in the audience there.
There's always a few beautiful young ladies at our show. Anywhere the Swav Gav is,
anywhere Swav Gav is,
there seems to be
right.
Beautiful ladies.
Coincidence? I think not.
No. I can actually see Mr. Arraw just about to get taken out by somebody in the crowd here.
Yeah, he's driving them absolutely mental. But this is a high stakes match. UEWA Heavyweight Championship on the line, and it's a huge opportunity for you, Inaugural. Huge definitely, opportunity.
Definitely. Also, just look at the atmosphere in this place. Look at the setting. I love the Bouncestation and can't wait to get back in there next year.
Absolutely, and it was packed to the rafters there, as you can see. The fans came and turned out for Pro2 Wrestling, turned out to see your stars like Andy Wild and Ewan Raw.
We don't get much bigger than that at Pro2. Two fantastic performers. And let's just say, once this match gets underway, the excitement's about to lift.
Absolutely. And it's only the fourth match in the show. And it's the UEWA Heavyweight Championship. It's unbelievable.
It's massive.
What a boon for Pro2 to have a star like Andy Wild who has. Oh, look at this.
Snuck in through the back door.
Oh, straight into that turnbuckle.
No giveaway there with Evie Powers. He felt that.
Yeah, now you've got to, with all the, you know, the playing to the crowd that Inaugural is doing, is he doing that to get in Andy Wild's head? Is this part of his game plan?
Without a doubt. Without a doubt, he is a cerebral assassin as far as I'm concerned. Oh. He'll get into the mind of Andy Wild. Andy Wells now thinking about him and not focusing on the fight.
Absolutely. You can see he had his knee into the back of Andy Wild there between the shoulder. Oh!
He's going to gas him with this, like.
Wow. Unbelievable. Just...
good old school academy rugby tackling there.
That's right. Just straight up into that corner. Oh, huge European uppercut. To reverse that Irish whip. Oh! Beautiful! A plethora of clotheslines, if you will. Oh, and straight over the top rope. That's how it's done.
Fantastic. Andy Wild getting on top of this. Eventually, it was me looking good for a while, kid.
And Inaugural doesn't know where he is. Oh!
I'll tell you where he's going. Rose Ed.
Oh, wow! Oh, that will not tickle. Look at this. Taking it into the crowd. Oh, my goodness. Oh! Can you imagine?
His heart skipped a beat.
Andy. Oh! Hold back, kid! That kid was not pulling his punch there.
No, it's like running the gauntlet here for Inaugural.
Yeah, well, he's antagonised the crowd, and now the crowd are having their fun. Oh, some of the most brutal chops in history are Andy Wild's.
The crowd being appreciative of the high fives being handed out to Andy Wild.
Ewan tried to kick the rope as Andy Wild came through it there. Didn't quite get all of it. Oh!
Referee gets one in the Nelga.
Chop, yeah.
Two count. Oh, I thought he had him there.
Well, I mean, certainly.
Look at the whelps in his chest, kid, for those slaps.
Oh! Brutal. Absolutely brutal. I think Ewan actually caught him in the eye there with a slap, I believe.
Certainly looked a little unorthodox.
Toe boots to the gut there. The ref wants to be keeping a close eye on that. I mean, these are two big men. Standing elbow drop. No one home there for Unoraw. It's hard to, in some ways it's hard to watch one of these matches because the shots are so big and brutal.
Definitely, they're feeling that. Oh, drop kick. Yeah. Ewan's getting that crowd riled again. Is this going to interfere with Andy Wilde's mental state?
Well, one can only imagine that at least on an audible level, and it must be incredibly frustrating to be in the ring with Unoraw.
Very much so.
The screaming and the...
Well, I'm going to be honest, kid, I'm annoyed.
Absolutely. Crowd are behind Andy Wilde, he's shouting, go Andy.
Nice
here.
Impact here.
Again, one of those arrogant style pins.
Yeah, you're never getting Andy Wilde. Never.
You don't take a man like Andy Wilde. That you know, you can't take him for a fool like that. That's
absolutely not. This guy's a seasoned performer.
I'm not just going through the arrogance of you. Know.
He's got what's a bit he of got? Wrist. It's illegal.
It's a bit of wrist tape there. Look at that. See him. He's unwrapping some wrist tape from his. Oh no! That's a clear and blatant choke.
It fell off me. I don't think so. VAR would have caught him out. That was a red card.
Yes, indeed. Although you could understand if wrist tape were to try and run away from you, you know.
Well, let's be honest. The amount of slaps and chokes that have been happening. These things are about to be getting loose.
Back elbow check there. You know that's not a fade on his head, it's the hair running away from his face.
Hair's running away from him. I think he's going for it.
He thinks he has his man finished. I would not count Andy Wilde out, let me tell you that. Is that an earthquake he's trying to do? Like, you know John Tenta?
I remember John Tenta. Did Tino become Golka?
Hey Dad, you know your history.
I know my history. He was actually a sumo champ before he went to the WWE.
Okay. Andy Wilde fighting back broadly here. Interesting about John Tenta. I actually saw John Tenta as a child at Irvine, at the Magnum, at the old Irvine. Old Irvine Magnum. That's
fantastic.
True story. And here we are back in Irvine all these years later. I must say it wasn't Pro2 Wrestling. Pro2 Wrestling didn't exist then. Oh, is he going for the big superplex? Maneuvering his man into position. I think he is going for the superplex, you know.
He's doing it.
Oh, wow.
He's doing it.
Oh, look
but
at the
ropes. Might just reverse this here and pull him out the ring.
The rope's straining under the weight of these two big men. Superplex. Unbelievable.
My. Not something you see every day.
It is not.
Andy, you've got to go for this pin. You've got him now. He's wasting his time, kid. He took a bit of pain himself there.
Yes, indeed. I mean, it's a high-risk manoeuvre, and it will hurt both competitors, but, you know, with big men like these, you have to pull out the big moves.
Without a doubt. Big-time players.
Going for his man. Big splash in the corner. Oh, did you see that? Stereo splash. Oh! Deadlift belly to belly. Oh.
Ooh, check out. That was well put together.
It was. A well put together sequence. That's where that training comes in. You know, they practice these moves, they practice these sequences. Oh, he's going for the gut wrench, but he didn't manage to get it. Toe to the gut.
Oh! Big boot!
Oh! Deadlift over the head, belly to belly.
One, two. Oh, thought he had him, kid.
Ewan's got his foot on
ring
the rope.
Awareness. Ring that's awareness. The experience. It's coming on for Mr. O'Rourke.
That saved him right there.
That ring awareness, just, you can't buy that.
Come on, dude. But did you see the sheer strength of Andy Wilde? That's that Stovey power. Here we go. He's successful with a gut wrench. Oh. I think Ewan managed to kind of escape that one. Oh!
Fisherman suplex. So close.
Did you notice he hooked the inside rather than the outside leg?
Yep.
Oh.
Very clever manoeuvre.
Shoulder capture. Slam there, I believe. Now you're seeing some of these big moves like that exploder we saw there and that shoulder capture. Slam. The size of these two guys in that ring. Man. That ring's going to be in the harbour sometime soon, let me tell you. Going to the top rope, dangerous, risky manoeuvre.
Oh my, missed!
Went for the Sauntaun Bomb, did not manage to get it. Oh! Gut wrench, slam! Oh, is it going? The Da Bomb! Unbelievable! He can count to 20 there.
He's not getting up.
That Da Bomb is just an unbelievable, unbelievable manoeuvre.
What a match. Fantastic. Very deserved, Andy Wilde, the Dad Bod God. Fantastic. UEWA put on a fight.
Oh yeah, I mean, you've got to give it to UEWA. I mean, he did take it to the champion.
His game, the lad, I've got to say, his game.
Absolutely. And, you know, when you're fighting for these championships, the age-old adage is that you have to take the belt from the champion.
Correct.
To show respect. And while his actions mostly did not show respect, and his words did not show respect, you've got to say UEWA did bring it to the champion.
Without a doubt, that was a fantastic contest. And I'm going to say, at the end of that match, a well-deserved winner.
Absolutely.
He pulled out all the stops, gave the crowd what he had, and he got it.
He did so. He's now over, I believe he's over 1,000 days into his reign as UEWA Heavyweight Champion.
1,000 days.
I believe so. Man of 1,000 days. And that's, you see on his shoulder there, that's what they're all gunning for, that UEWA Heavyweight Championship. And Pro2 is now proud to be part of the UEWA family.
It's fantastic. The company has just grown fantastically. Things are coming along swimmingly.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's I'm here with Mr. Ewan O'Rourke. Ewan, you've just had an incredibly difficult match against Andy Wilde, and it's fair to say that the result did not go your way. And I don't think there's any shame to that. That's just this interviewer's opinion. But what are your thoughts and feelings after that match?
Well, Andy, what I'll say is all week I've been talking about how I'm going to become the new UEWA Heavyweight Champion. Tonight, this was the biggest match of my career. And I came into it with a bit of a bad attitude. I came in too confident. I thought I was going to win. I thought it was a sure thing. Andy, I learned tonight what everybody's been saying about you for the last few years. But you're one of the best heavyweights, not just in this country, but in the world. And tonight, it might have not been my night, but we'll be back in that ring sooner than you think. So for me, I just need to go back to the drawing board. I need to think about what 2022 holds for the big strong man in Pro2. And next year, you're going to see me with championship gold in Pro2. Can't stop, won't stop.
I'm here with the UEWA Heavyweight European Champion, Mr. Andy Wilde. Andy, you've just been victorious against the big strong man, Ewan O'Rourke, who is on excellent form right now. What's the Dad Bod God's thoughts and feelings after that particular encounter?
Yeah, I mean, Ewan O'Rourke took me to the absolute limit. And that's what we've got to look for at this stage, contenders that can take the UEWA Heavyweight Champion to the absolute limit. If you want to see more of this, if you want to see more of Unstoppable Andy Wilde, the Dad Bod God, fighting at Pro2, you book your tickets because you're going to be in for more Wild Nights Out.
This next bout is scheduled for a fall of one. Introducing first, the Asian sensation, Umar Mohammed.
And here we are, Umar Mohammed, the Asian sensation.
Fantastic performer is Mr. Mohammed.
Kissing that trophy there, I'm not entirely sure what he's got that for.
Self-gratification.
Crowd letting Umar Mohammed know.
He's certainly not the fan favourite, kid. But still a performer, nonetheless.
Oh, yes, indeed. Now, he didn't even wait for his music to get properly started, he just came straight out. This man is here for a fight. Caleb Valhalla.
Typical Viking. Does what he wants, when he wants.
Absolutely clogged up.
A fantastic performer again. This is going to be a contest.
Yes, he's a true heavyweight as Caleb Valhalla. He's actually the Fair City Wrestling heavyweight champion.
And deservedly so.
What's cut out for him tonight with Umar Mohammed? Without
a doubt, Umar Mohammed is a good performer and he's quick. Now Valhalla's a big lad, he's quick, but he's not as quick as Mohammed.
Oh yeah. Look, I'm calling down the power from the North Gods.
Just when you're speaking about power, this guy is full of power, and that's where Mr. Mohammed has to be careful.
Absolutely, I mean, that's exactly where that power advantage is going.
I'm the Asian sensation here, you should be chatting my name!
That's about full of himself, this fellow, isn't
he? Well, we'll see if it's a ridiculous demand. It's certainly sounding like one.
And we are underway. See the look on Umar Mohammed's face. He's screaming. Wise to get his head in between those ropes and get the referee to move Caleb Valhalla back.
Without a doubt, the time wasting element, even though there's no time limit, that time wasting causes frustration. Oh.
Oh, just picked up like a bag of potatoes. Unbelievable.
That's the power we were talking about, kid.
Oh, huge overhand chop.
That was more like a thump right into the chest.
It was, that'll cave your chest right in. Slammed him from pillar to post here.
Another pound.
Yes, indeed. I see what you're saying. It's, oh, that is definitely more of a thump than a thump.
Oh, he feels that right to his back.
Oh, it's all Umar can do to keep the man off of him at the moment. Oh, going for the power slam.
He just threw him like a rag doll.
Absolutely, what an unbelievable release power slam. Umar Mohammed is on crazy street right now. He does not know where he is. Look, going for that, targeting that leg, I believe.
He just doesn't have the strength to get the big man. Oh,
gut wrench.
I think we'll call that just get off.
Yeah, I'm trying to call him as specific wrestling moves, but I mean, it's just a gut wrench, a release gut wrench.
That was an off the dome Viking. I'm doing it. Get off me.
There we go. Oh. Oh. nearly fell into our cameraman there.
There's a very raw feel about Valhalla.
Oh, absolutely, yeah. Incredibly, incredibly intense competitor. Oh!
Oh! That, I felt that, and he felt nothing.
I mean, those squared off edges, that'll get to anybody eventually, I mean, surely. It's just steel, that's all it is. Nothing fancy, a padded or...
It's not moving. Oh.
Dragon screw takedown! Oh!
It actually looked like that nearly hyperextended the other way it went down.
It did. I'm beginning to see that Umar Mohammed's game plan here is targeting that left leg of Caleb Valhalla.
Without a doubt, he knows there's a weakness here now.
Oh, go for a knee bar there.
Back when my day we used to call that a knee DD.
A knee DD. I like that. I'm going to steal that.
Steal that. It's a Pro 2 original.
A Pro 2 original. I love to see it.
Just got him backed up in this corner. There's no escape here for Umar Mohammed.
Absolutely. Just Caleb slinging him.
Oh my!
Launched him up in the air. Just stepped out like it was nothing.
Thankfully, that wasn't venue 38. He would have stuck to the ceiling.
That's believable. Yeah, the ceilings are too high in here even for Caleb Valhalla to stick with Umar Mohammed.
If anybody's going to be able to get him up there, it's Valhalla.
Absolutely.
The man is just a monster.
He is. And we're seeing that right now. Oh. Did you see that there? He's grabbing at his leg. He was trying to get him up there for the suplex, I believe, but couldn't
quite tackle. Flying knee, standing flying knee.
Absolutely.
And he's got the sense to hook the back leg and keep stretching away at it.
Absolutely, yeah. As you do rightly point out, he did go for that outside leg. Oh! Kick. Trying to wield it. He's got that leg hooked through the rope.
Definitely hyperextending that knee.
Absolutely. Oh, drop kick, shotgun drop kick to the knee through the rope. The referee wants to keep a close eye on this. It's not legal to use the rope in that manner.
This cruciate ligament may go.
It may well do. I mean, that's going to start causing real problems for Caleb here soon. Holding on to that rope. Oh, forearm smash. You see him limping there now, he's definitely injured that leg.
Yeah. He's heavily favouring looking at it.
Oh.
Like, is it gonna give way? This leg might just give way.
Unbelievable. Oh, he's going for the power bomb, but Umar Mohammed manages to roll it through to a pinning attempt. Oh, he's hitting the knee, you're punching the knee, kicking. Unbelievable. You know, what guts from Umar Mohammed here, let's be honest.
Disarm a man and he can't shoot his gun.
Just a knee to the side of the head there as well.
Mohammed being relentless here, not giving up on him.
Putting that leg up on the rope again.
Is he going to actually jump on this leg?
Oh! Wow! German suplex with the release. Unbelievable. He just threw him across the ring.
Like he wasn't there.
It's like a ragdoll. Big splash in the corner there. Oh! Ripcord clothesline as well.
Shades of Jake the Snake.
Caleb going for that pin, but you do see he's limping, and Umar Mohammed will be seeing that limping and thinking, I've got to capitalise on this.
He's going to capitalise, you just know he's thinking it. He's spent all match. Running him down, there you go.
Oh, it's the kick to the
head straight into the turnbuckle as well.
You know, kicking that knee so that the joint goes the wrong way around. Oh, unbelievable. Oh.
Knees to the back. That's got you hurt.
Yeah.
man.
Going for a fisherman suplex, it looks like, but oh, Caleb. Oh, see, again, Caleb had a move line up there, but he couldn't capitalize because of that leg.
He's slowed his game right down. DDT.
DDT, unbelievable. Going for that outside leg pull up. I've got to say, you have to give credit to Umar Mohammed. Going for that outside leg in the pin and attempt.
But I have to be honest, that was a half-hearted pin he could have had him if he had just put the attention to detail in. Still working in that leg.
Hear the growls of Caleb Valhalla, he's getting angry.
Oh. I wouldn't be doing that, pal.
Oh. Oh. Clubbing blows in the corner, unbelievable.
From Viking to caveman.
Going for the power bomb. Power bomb! Gee whiz.
I felt that for here.
Oh, I thought that was going to be.
I honestly thought he had on myself. How did he manage to kick out for that one?
That's got to be sheer resilience. Just sheer desperation. Whoa! Got him a cross body hold there. Oh! Umar going for the. He's got him in an ankle lock. Oh! That's going to be taking that pressure all the way down to the knee, to the hip. Oh! Caleb with a clever reversal there, put his weight down on the back of his knee. But again, that gets him out of the hole, but it's going to hurt him when his knee goes smashing down onto the canvas.
Without a doubt, there's no giving that ring.
No, I mean, it's just pain in below that canvas. But the canvas is simply there just to
do
stop
not
you getting scaled.
Solid steel rafters that do not give.
Absolutely. Oh, again, he's going for that ankle lock. Caleb's trying to reach that rope. Oh! Going for the knee bar.
This is it. It's over.
He's transitioned that ankle lock to something of a... he's got the rope there. Oh, my God.
Saved by the rope.
To the knuckle cries of Caleb Valhalla. Oh! Oh my God! That was a knee straight to the... That was painful to
sheer
watch.
Brutality. He's got him now, kid.
Yeah, he's got that. That knee bar is in deep. That is so deep. Yeah!
Figure four! Oh my! Reverse figure four!
Oh, yeah. Caleb has no choice but to tap there. He can't get to a rope. He can't get his man off him.
Come on, let him go!
Jeez.
I'll tell you. Dirty performer, once that bell rings, you've got to let that go. The damage it could now be done to Valhalla, that could be career ending.
Absolutely, I mean, you've got to watch out for those ligaments, those joints. But Umar Mohammed, I mean, the win goes in the books. He's stuck to his game plan and he's won.
To be honest, you're absolutely correct, kid. For a man coming in against the pillar of Valhalla to come out with that victory, especially the way he was getting tossed about.
And he's absolutely exhausted. Look at that. He just falls face first to the canvas without any.
Keep it up, a good fight. Both guys, another entertaining contest. We should get it pro too.
Absolutely. I mean, it's only the second match in. And
what we've got to remember, this was only the third show.
Oh yeah, I mean, absolutely. I mean, Pro2 is growing as a company. You know, we're putting on the best matches that we can, that the fans want to see.
And we're getting to see it.
The crowd showing their appreciation for Caleb Valhalla.
And rightly so. A great fierce, performer.
Fierce competitor.
Without a doubt.
Yeah, I mean, just that knee bar was just locked in so deep.
I'd love to see him back at Pro2.
Absolutely. So, as would I. I'm going to try and grab an interview with him.
Definitely. You might need an interpreter.
Kit Thompson here with Caleb Valhalla after your very taxing match against Umar Mohammed. And I'm afraid to say that you didn't quite come away with the win on this particular occasion.
No, the mighty Caleb lost today. And I can still feast and revel and drink. But it's not the same. It's not the same after a loss. But Omar fought well. Clearly he had a game plan. He focused on my foot and my leg. And it worked for him today. Not much more than mighty Caleb can say.
Will the North gods be happy with the effort that you put in? I'm sure they will.
Yeah.
From this fan's perspective.
The ACR always look down on me. I'm sure they have a great plan. And with their guidance, the mighty Caleb just keeps going on to the next fight, until he ends in Valhalla.
Thank you very much for joining me, Mr. Valhalla.
No problem, thank you. To rebel!
There you have it.
Pro2 Wrestling is sponsored by Car Repair 24. Car Repair 24 carries out work for Scotland's leading insurance companies and offers free and honest advice with fully insured and guaranteed repairs, giving you complete peace of mind. For more information on Car Repair 24, check out the website at cr24ltd.co.uk or on Facebook at Car Repair 24. Car Repair 24, top quality car repairs in Ayrshire.
The next match will be an elimination match for the Bells Women's Championship.
And here we are at Pro Tuesday, and this is for the gold in the ladies division, the Bells Championship. And we have Julia Phoenix presenting the belt. Wab Gab. Pass to the referee so they can go to the crowd.
Introducing first to the ring,
women's division.
Vega.
Always high energy. Always exciting.
And this is, I believe, a four-way match.
Four-way contest.
But we don't know who the fourth competitor is going to be.
Ah, so we have a wild card.
Yeah, okay.
Ashley Vega, though, she's no wild card.
No, indeed. Professional, many years of experience in the ring, and she'll be gunning for this championship, make no mistake about it.
Definitely a worthwhile competitor, worthwhile challenger, and quite possibly could be a worthwhile champion, kid.
Quite possible. I would never count Ashley Vega out.
Next to the ring, Rosie Nyte!
And here the fans going wild there. Rosie Nyte is a fan favourite.
Without a doubt, Rosie's another high energy performer. Another worthy opponent, worthy of that belt.
Absolutely, this match is shaping up to be a barnstormer.
The only thing is, the four people in the ring, there's a lot of arms and legs you've got to worry about.
Absolutely, there's a lot of... It's difficult to stick to a game plan when there's three other competitors against you.
I don't know, I remember fighting an octopus once.
Where was that, the...
That was at the Sea Life Centre.
The seafood restaurant down at the harbour.
I don't do seafood. As you can see, I've lost a bit of weight. I used to seafood and I would eat it. No, now. Kid, you're looking spliff in the day, pal.
Oh, thank you. And another lady's looking spliffing is Harmony Skye, a new competitor in our division.
Harmony Skye. Don't know a lot about Harmony Skye. Oh, I doubt we're about to find out.
This is, I believe, only a second match.
She certainly looks the part, kid.
Yeah, but I must say, she seems to have aligned herself with Ashley Vega. I don't know if that's a good move or not.
Do you think there's going to be allies getting connected in this match, or is it going to be a brawl for all?
I mean, depends what each lady's game plan is, but who is the wild card here? Oh! It's Ruby Roberts!
No, neither.
The basic bitch slayer, the scarlet bitch herself!
Ruby Roberts, another experienced competitor.
Absolutely, and she's having a lot of success both domestically and internationally right now, and you love to see it.
All that hard work, you only get back what you put in, kid.
Oh, absolutely, and the fans love to see her as well. She did a personal appearance a couple of weeks before the show to promote the show down here at Bouncestation, and by all accounts that went very, very well. The fans just love Ruby Roberts.
What's not to love, kid?
Who wins in this match? I'd have to say, peripherally, I'd have to say the fans, basically. It's, you know, you got four amazing Bells Division competitors here. Oh, and you see Rubi and Rosie have made a pact there of sorts. Oh! Stereo kicks. A little bit of dozy-do. Oh!
Looks like we've pledged allegiances already, pal.
Looks like it. Oh! Malfunction at the junction.
Well, it's left two out the ring and two to get on with it. Rosie Nyte.
Oh! Shoulder check to the mat. Look, nice leap over, but she caught her leg on the way over there. Oh, pulling the hair, ref, pulling the hair. Now, oh, running bulldog. Now, I expect to see great things from Harmony Sky, being that she does come from that FPWA training school.
I've got to be honest here.
Oh!
You wouldn't say it was her second match.
Oh, no, absolutely not. Oh, Ashley Vega coming in from behind there, like a vulture looking to scoop up the win. And then there are three other competitors in there with her, so she has to be pick a spot, be careful, be tactical.
Oh, she's got to think about conserving that energy.
Oh yeah. Ooh, I'm not entirely sure what she has on there, at least a bow and arrow of sorts. Oh yes, I see what you're saying. It's a reverse chin lock there.
Yeah, chin lock's in hard. Although, if she was using her knee against her back just to get a bit of extra leverage, it would have really made her suffer.
Absolutely. Oh, slamming her head off the mat there.
Well, if it gets the results.
The referee's got a hard job on his hands here, keeping an eye on all these competitors.
Very much so.
Oh, brutal European uppercut there from Ashley Vega to Ruby Roberts. What's she going for here? Oh, going for a suplex, but Ruby has wrapped her leg around there to stop her. Ah, comes back with a snap suplex of her own. Beautifully done. She hooked both legs there. Try and capitalise on that pin attempt. Oh.
Ashley Vega not happy about the performance here. Ruby Roberts and getting tore right in.
Oh,
turned into a right bitch fest.
It has been. Oh. Oh no.
Did you see how she just rubbed her foot right down her face to get to her throat there?
Absolutely unbelievable. As I said, the referee's going to have a hard job distinguishing between legitimate moves and actual chokes here.
Yeah, the nasty bits in some of these women.
Oh, right off that squared off steel edge.
Don't think we'll be seeing Rosie for a little while.
It's turned into a bit of a handicap situation with Harmony Skye and Ashley Vega teaming up on Ruby Roberts here. Oh! Punt kick to the mat. Ashley Vega letting her have it verbally as well. You know, it's anything that you can do to gain an advantage of any sort here.
Without a doubt, without a doubt.
Be it psychological or... Oh! Pulling the hair and... Oh! The referee just throwing his hands up in despair here. Oh! So Ashley Vega's not happy that Harmony tried to take that pin there.
Definitely not.
Now, it is an elimination style contest here.
Ashley Vega seems to be orchestrating the demise of Ruby Roberts.
Oh, indeed. Oh! Beautiful drop kick from the second rope there. Again, I'm impressed with Harmony Skye's moveset. I'm... Oh! Are we seeing a bit of unhappiness in the camp here? I mean, Ruby Roberts has been eliminated, unfortunately, in this
elimination
contest.
Honestly,
I
thought she had her there.
Ruby Roberts has been eliminated.
She did have her. Ruby's gone. So now we're going to end up with a 2-on-1. Oh no!
There's a bit. Talk about harmony. That's a bit
changing
of
the air.
Yep.
What a quick roll up!
Rosie stacked her up there for the. Oh, there you go. Ashley Vega was only out for herself after all.
Always, always.
And that is a hard lesson to learn for this rookie competitor. But she, you know, she's learned it here tonight, I believe.
Harmony Skye will be back.
Yeah, there's a bit of disharmony going on there.
Without a doubt, kid.
Nope. Slide out to outside. Chaos is chasing Ashley around there now. Back into the ring. Yep. Seasoned competitor. Waiting for a lady who's back in the ring and just stomped on her. Oh! Faced in the mat as well.
Now when it's coming to power, it's all down to Ashley Vega now.
Yeah, you've got to give that power advantage to Ashley Vega.
Rosie's now got to use that ring experience to take her down.
And the quickness as well would have to be on Rosie Knight's side, I would believe.
Without a doubt.
Ooh! Brutal, absolutely brutal.
Could be the end.
Jawbreaker! Very clever from Rosie Knight there, very clever to utilise that. You love to see it. Tuning up the band, going for the super kick.
Chin music!
She's got the referee!
Oh!
Referee moved into the way. Did Ashley pull him into the way? Is that what happened? Oh! Face buster. Thinking here, Slav Dav.
I'm thinking she's grabbing the belt. Yeah, she is. Is she going to use it illegally while the referee's down?
No, you hate to see this.
Especially when you've got to pay for it. She's going for it.
Watch out, Rosie. Oh, she got all of that.
And the rest.
Now she has the job of waking the referee up to capitalise on this pin. Now you've got to say the referee was discombobulated there.
Without a doubt, that was a slow count, but again,
Rosie Knight is still in this. But for how much longer?
Down and out. Well, the tide's certainly going towards Ashley Vega.
Oh my goodness. Crowd letting Ashley Vega know they don't approve of these underhand tactics. Oh, moving her up to the top rope. What's she going for here? Oh, the big forearms. Oh! Rosie Knight returning fire. Oh! Giving two to take one. Oh! Spinning DDT from the top rope.
Has she got her?
She's got her! Oh, that top rope manoeuvre.
Fantastic, like you said, it's that speed. Did Ashley Vega see that coming?
Oh, you know, speed kills. And it only takes 3 seconds to win a wrestling match. And she's won the Bells Division Women's Championship.
And deservedly so. four-way bout. Not the easiest to come through, and to come through and be champion, that's off to Rosie Nyte.
Absolutely. There you go. Oh, the crowd love it. The crowd love it.
Let's be honest. They love to see it.
Absolutely, Squad, so you do. But you know what, if you want to see matches like this, Pro2 is the go-to, baby.
It's the only place, without a doubt, the most up-and-coming wrestling establishment in Scotland, hopefully soon to be the UK. And there's no reason why that can't extend to Europe now that we're in the UEWA.
Yep, we are in the UEWA family.
So let's just see what talent it's going to bring.
I could be wrong on this, but I think that would make make all of our belts European championship.
I think it's spot on with that kid.
I mean, they're certainly being competed for at a European level.
Without a doubt, we're at that level.
Yes, well, I believe we'll have to wait for confirmation on that, but I don't see why not.
Well, the waiting game is the game.
Well, look at that, Rosie Nyte celebrating after a hard fought match against three other competitors.
Did well.
You know, you love to see it. She's letting a fat in there have a shot at the belt. Look how happy he is. That's what Pro2 is about, Slavgar.
Without a doubt.
The happiness of the fans.
And the family, because the fans are part of the family, kid.
I'm joined here by Harmony Skye. Now, we have just crowned the Bells Division Women's Champion. Unfortunately, it's not Harmony Skye.
No.
Despite being doing pretty much anything to win. So, what are your thoughts and feelings after that match?
You know what, the way tonight went is not exactly how I put myself out there. I tried to do everything. I had Ashley Vega take a hold of me tonight. I was under her influence. I must admit, she did get in my head a bit. Cost me the title tonight. However, the next time you see Harmony Skye, I want to remind everyone watching here that that is not how I do things. I do things by the rules, I win by the rules, and next time I will win that championship. Thank you.
And thank you for joining me. I'm joined once again by Ruby Roberts. Obviously very frustrating for you. And three matches in Pro2 and three losses. What are you thinking?
Something's got to change. I have not shown what Ruby Roberts can do, and I need to do that, so something needs to change. I need to train harder, get better, revamp a lot. I will come back here bigger and better. Something's going to change. Ruby Roberts is going to change, and I will not be the underdog anymore. I will dominate this competition.
You obviously feel very strongly, and I can't wait to see what's next for Ruby Roberts, but I'll let you get on after that match.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Ruby. Appreciate you. Thank you.
See you later.
Pro2 Wrestling is sponsored by Car Repair 24. Car Repair 24 carries out work for Scotland's leading insurance companies and offers free and honest advice with fully insured and guaranteed repairs, giving you complete peace of mind. For more information on Car Repair 24, check out the website at cr24ltd.co.uk or on Facebook at Car Repair 24. Car Repair 24, top quality car repairs in Ayrshire.
I'm joined by Rosie Nyte after what must have been an incredibly difficult match. But, you said it in our last interview, you're here to hold the gold. And hold the gold you do.
Yeah.
How are you feeling?
I mean, the fan support, absolutely ridiculous. Did not expect that, but do you know what? It's the fans that keep you going. They make you strive to get that belt, to keep them happy. You want to make the fans feel like they're a part of it. And also, it was hard going. It was three other brutal women. I mean, you've got Ashley Vega, who definitely put up a fight. I mean, I ate my belt before I got the belt.
Wow, yeah, I know.
You've got Harmony Skye, absolute fantastic worker. Could see her and Ash having a wee fallout, but we'll see. And then Ruby, absolutely fantastic. So yes, it was a match that I went in with knowing that I needed to put my all in. No matter how many times they tried to get rid of me,
I would come back fighting stronger.
Yeah, well, you did a great job. It was a tremendous match, and you absolutely deserve to hold the gold.
Definitely.
So thank you so much.
You're welcome. For thank you.
Interviewing with me, and thanks for putting on that amazing match.
Thank you.
Wow, what an episode of Pro Tuesday that was! But let me tell you guys, it's still freezing around here, so we're going to turn up the heat. In next week's episode, we've got a mystery festive guest to look out for. I don't know who that could be. We've also got the nastiest, most hated man in Ayrshire, Bobby Roberts, taking on strutting Frank Cross, the sheriff of Pro 2 Wrestling. But as well as that, we've got the most mysterious man in all of wrestling, Zero, taking on Scotland's favourite luchador, Lucha Diaz. But as well as that, we've got the main event, Adam Shame, the Paisley Wrecking Machine, taking on Kryger, taking on wildcard TJ Rage. So it's all to play for, and all I can say is, guys, are you pro too? I'll see you in the next episode.